Hey YouTube, what's up? To be honest with you, I have made this video twice. The first version was a pretty normal review with a focus on the small size of the camera. I compared it with the infamous Olympus OM1, which is also a really small camera. But boring. So I will give you more of an insight of the love and hate relationship I have with this camera. So stay tuned for great frustrating moments with me and the Pentax ME. Before we start, I would like to thank you all and welcome to all newcomers here on this channel. Through my recipe video, my channel has literally exploded. And if you found your way here through this video, then please subscribe and become part of this really great community. Back to the Pentax. So, why did I bought the Pentax in the first place? I actually randomly bought it on a flea market here in Germany. And a nice gentleman was selling his son's complete camera collection, and the Pentax was in absolute fabulous condition. Not mint, but really good. So you could say it was the German version of.
I picked it up from a thrift store for $5.
I cleaned the mirror, replaced the mirror damper and put two LR44s and voila, it worked flawlessly. So I went right out and shot some pictures with it. With the camera, I got the Pentax M50mm 1.7 SMC, a really sharp lens. It's nice and small to match the camera. This lens is bursting with micro contrast. This example was shot at f4. The bokeh is soft, has good transition and has no swirl characteristic. A very good performance, even wide open. There's hardly anything to complain about, even in the corners. Just a bit of vignetting, as you can see here. Let's get to the things I love about this camera besides the great image quality. The build quality is great. Everything is clicky, snappy, and feels pretty premium. Small design details suggest a playfulness and precision of the designers. The focus ring is the smoothest one I have ever used. The shutter speed range is between 8 seconds and 1/1000th of a second. The ISO range is between 25 and 6100. The camera has a large viewfinder and so leave little to be desired. All this in the smallest camera body there is. It's even 30 grams lighter than the OM1. Take a look at the difference to an A1. The Canon A1 looks really massive against the small camera and even weighs 200 grams more. What does the sniff test say? The build quality on this camera is really top notch and even better than the Canon A1. But not everything is positive, so let's come to the negative sides of the Pentax ME. The camera is fully electronic and has no manual shutter speed selection, so only aperture priority. So I'm really fighting against this camera in different light situations. Oftentimes I only use Sunny 16, and I don't even need a light meter, and this camera really reminds me why that is. I'll give you an example. You are photographing a person facing the sun. The light meter will expose clearly for the highlights. Okay, you take the camera and correct the somewhat sluggish compensation dial to +2 overexposure. But sometimes this is not enough for dark parts in the shadow, so you correct the ISO dial from 200 to ISO 100. You look through the viewfinder and see that the light meter again wants to expose one aperture too bright. So you turn the compensation dial down again, look through the viewfinder only to find out that the light meter is showing something else again. The only thing you want to do then is throw the camera against the nearest wall. That's why I often just work with the 1/100th of a second shutter speed. And shutter speed that's available without batteries, just to avoid fiddling with the compensation dial. What also happens that in darker situations the camera uses shutter speeds that cannot be handheld, like 1/13th or 1/15th of a second. So you have to watch out for this. Yeah, I'm really split in my opinion with this camera. On one hand, the camera has such a high build quality and produces such awesome sharp images. On the other hand, with this aperture priority, it drives me crazy. You know what would have solved this problem? An auto exposure lock. So simple, Pentax. Pentax probably heard the same thing back in the day and released the same camera again with a manual mode called the Pentax ME Super. You can simply go for the Pentax MX, which is completely manual. But this one has no automatic modes, which I personally prefer. So, if you're just starting out and looking for a super cheap, reliable camera with high build quality, you don't do street photography and a lot of portraits, then go for it. For all others, I recommend to put this aside and look for an ME Super or an MX. I have to admit, I probably won't keep this camera because I have a whole closet full of other cameras I have to make reviews on, and if you don't want to miss this, then please subscribe. So if you have a question about this camera or anything else in the video, then please leave a comment. Until next time guys, take care, bye!